If you are an electronics hobbyist like me, you probably have a lot of development boards like Arduino boards, ESP32 boards, and many more. If you have followed my channel long enough and watched my videos, you might already know that I have made many things with ESP32, like a walkie-talkie, internet radios, remote controls, etc. After all this experience with the ESP32, I think it is time for me to build my own ESP32 development board. I will show you how I did it in this video, so keep watching! This video is sponsored by pcbway. To build my own board, I first need to draw my schematic. To make my own schematic, I collected a lot of schematics from the internet to find out which one is better and which components are needed. Thanks to many open source projects, I can collect enough schematics. If you go through them many times, you will find out what they have in common and what the minimal component is needed to make it work. I usually use KiCad to design PCBs for my projects. This time, I decided to try another PCB design software. As usual, the most time-consuming part of the design process was routing the component connections. This may be because I placed many components in a relatively small area of the PCB. The features of this board are, first, I added 3 buttons, which could be useful for operations like navigating through menus. Next, 4 new pixel LEDs are included in the design. They can be used for visual feedback to the user. To display more advanced information, I also added 2 types of display sockets to the design. One is for a 0.96 inch OLED display, and the other is for a 240 by 240 display using SPI protocol. As always, I ordered the PCB from pcbway, and they arrived within a few days. They also gave me a surprise. I love this PCB ruler. And this PCB gadget. Oh, I see, it's a surface mount footprint reference guide. Look at this amazing PCB quality. I really love it. Okay, now it's time to solder. In the previous video, since I already had some experience soldering surface mount components with a hot air gun, the soldering went quite well this time. I had no particular problems. I started this project, I had the idea to make a development board with my own features. So I want to make sure that it is implemented the way I imagined it. First, I will test the RGB LEDs. I have four of them mounted on my board. As you can see, they work fine. To control these RGB LEDs, I use a fast LED library. I use GPIO pin number 19 as a data input pin to match the configuration of this board. By programming, you can freely change the light timing pattern and color of LEDs. This is useful when you want to have visual feedback for your operations. The next thing to check is the 240 by 240 display. This one also works fine using the SPI protocol. What you see in the demo is the result of running the sample code. This display is perfect for a compact electronic project, neither too big nor too small. When programming in combination with the three input buttons, it could be used to implement simple games. Next is the OLED display. This is another component that is readily available and widely used by hobbyists. It is also easy to use and can be set up quickly and easily with an I2C connection. Sometimes some of these display modules have the ground and VCC pins reversed, so I also prepared two patterns of the socket. It might be the easiest component to display data and status for a simple project. With my board, these two types of displays are standard and ready to plug and play. Last but not least, I have provided two Grove connectors on this board. These are also I2C connectors, so you should be able to use any I2C sensors and other modules that use I2C Grove cables. I have also designed a socket for an I2C pin header on the board. This will allow you to use any module that communicate via I2C. Shown here is Husky Dance, which can be configured to switch to I2C or UART communication. It can be set to I2C communication and then connected to my board. As you can see, the board receives the human face position information detected by the Husky lens. Well, I guess that's it. I hope you enjoyed following along as I build my own ECB32 development board. Oh, one more thing. Since I made two of them, we can do some remote control with the ESP Now protocol. As you can see, it works well. Now I can confidently say that my ESP32 development board project is a success. In my next project, I will show you how I combine the ESP32 module with the RP2040 chip to experiment with this exciting combination. Make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss the next video like this. Thanks for watching and see you next time!